What's going on, everybody? It's your boy Bav back again with another video, and today in this video I'm actually taking you guys along with me in screen printing from start to finish on t-shirts, long sleeves, and actual zip-up hoodies. So without further ado, let's go talk about what we're printing. First and foremost, if you're new to the channel, welcome to the video. My name is Bav and I run a custom apparel screen printing and embroidery company all out of my own shop. And this business grew from the ground up from my parents' basement. You can literally go back to the videos and watch exactly the process of growing this business. And we're gonna keep growing from here on out. And I'm documenting the whole process and journey to show you all that you guys can do it too. But without further ado, let's go talk about the project we're working on in this video. Now, we got a good amount of t-shirts that we're going to be screen printing today, and then we'll also have some zip-up hoodies as well. Now, all of this is going to have a two-color screen print on the front and a two-color screen print on the back. So, let's go print our film positives, and then let's start making our screen. So, come with me. Positives printed, let's go ahead and start exposing our screen. So let me run you through that process. Now that we're here in the dark room where all of our screen making happens, hence this is why we have a yellow safe light here and all of our freshly coated screens right there that are unexposed and ready to be stenciled out with this design. So let's run through that process. Now what's happening in this process is the screen is getting exposed to light. Now keep in mind, whatever that green emulsion touches to light, it hardens so it doesn't wash out. But this part, hence why it's black, it blocks the light from hitting that emulsion, which weakens it up and it's unexposed. So when we go to wash it out, it just washes out like magic. And that's how screen print screens are made. It's kind of like a magical process and it's satisfying to watch. So let's go wash this out once it's done exposing. Now remember when I told you whenever the light hits that emulsion, it hardens, and whenever it doesn't hit the emulsion, it's weak and unexposed. So when it's touched with water, it basically weakens itself up. As you see, when I hit it with water, you can automatically start to see that design start to appear. And that process is basically because that film positive that we had, which was a black sheet, blocks the light from hitting the emulsion, but everything around it hardens. So when we go to hit it with water, it just washes itself out. Pro tip, I like to get the screen wet a little bit first because this helps you expose the screen. I don't just automatically go in there with a pressure washer and try to get it open. I just got it wet on both sides. Remember, you do both sides, and then try to let it sit for like 30 seconds. Let the water weaken that emulsion up, so when you come back with a pressure washer, it's much easier. And that's all we need. So let's go expose it. And now we have a perfectly exposed screen printing screen. So I'm gonna basically rinse and repeat the process for the rest of the screens, and I'll see you in the next shot. Now that you know exactly how those screen printing screens are made, let's go ahead and start mixing up our custom ink colors. In this case, we need just one custom color, which is Pantone 299C, because the client wanted a turquoise slash light blue color for the print to be on the gray t-shirts and the black t-shirts. So we're gonna go ahead and mix that up. What we do is we have a custom ink mixing system that we use. So we go ahead and input that formula, the Pantone color, and it kicks back a formula, which is basically ingredients like you're cooking, but in this case, we're making ink. So in this case, we just have two ingredients, which is our white ink and our blue ink. So we're gonna go ahead and use those colors to the exact ratio that's right here and then mix them up. So come with me. Now that you saw exactly how the screen printing screens are made and exactly how we mix custom Pantone colors when it comes to screen printing inks, let's go ahead and take the next steps to actually start screen printing on the garments. But before we do that, if you want to stay in touch with me or get custom apparel orders done just like this order right here or many other orders, go ahead and reach out to me at Aesthetic Imprints. Check out our Instagram page because we're posting on there on a daily basis on what we're working on for clients and whoever we're printing for. We usually post highlights all the time. And if you wanna see exactly, get some inspiration or whatever, go ahead and check us out there and make sure you follow the personal brand page, BaavProductions, because that's where you see inside looks of me and these videos and when they're coming out, and when they do come out, you wanna be known, right? Anyways, let me give you guys an inside look of what production floor looks like now and what we're working on, because there's a good amount of jobs in queue and they...
So we got these jobs to do that I'm going to take you through the whole process with. And then we got these fresh, keep the family fresh t-shirts. These are on some premium LA apparel t-shirts. And then we got this. And then, of course, we got some mesh shorts in the works. Because it's that season, it's getting hot, people want the mesh shorts. And then we got some more shock aware garments right here, shock aware, and more garments right there, ready to go.
So as you can see, production floor is pretty busy and we got some good jobs in the queue. And if you want to be in that queue, make sure you reach out to us. But anyways, let's get back to the video. And now it's time to go ahead and get the screens on the screen print press and get them registered up. So come with me. Now, how I like to line up my multicolor registration is I put my transparency sheet right here. And then I just bring my sheet down and make sure all screens are registered to that same spot. So I'm gonna do that. Got those multicolor prints registered up, let's go ahead and tape off the corners of the screen, start loading it up with ink and doing some test prints. So let's do it. Thank you. just like that, we got the test prints done, and those turned out fantastic the first try. So let's go ahead and start getting everything ready to print. But before we do that, my pallets are low on tack, so I'm gonna go ahead and replace the pallet tape to add extra tack on there. So let's do that. Everybody, now that the pallet tape is all fresh and ready to go, and I did one last final test print without the registration marks, and as you see, that looks perfect. So without further ado, let's begin full production. Screen printing, making sure your platens have sticky glue on them is very important. And when you're using water-based adhesive, it tends to get fuzzy like this. And a quick way to activate the glue again is to actually scrub it with water and a scrub pad. Now, you can manually do this, or there's a better way. Check this out. Takes is a generic drill with a scrub pad attachment, and it's easy as that. Life has never been the same since I moved to this. And that was a solid video of me taking you all along with me in depth in the screen print process of getting this job done for my customer. Now, I gotta be real, this video is about a month or two old from where I am right now. I've just been so busy that I haven't even been able to edit these videos and get them out for you guys, but I finally got around to it and edited it now. But in that time frame, there's been a bunch of things that happened in the shop that changed, like that dryer right there. We got a new dryer in this video. We were using that Riley Hopkins, but as you can see now, we have a new dryer. So yeah, this is our new 11-foot dryer, and this makes our old dryer look like a baby. And part of the reason why I've been behind on content is because honestly, business has just been booming. That's a great problem to have, but we've been having hundreds and thousands of shirts being printed through these doors, and it's just stressful and cuts my time thin. So I don't have enough time to make content because I'm literally here till past midnight, literally almost on a daily basis. I'm working 80 plus hours a week just grinding. But that's not gonna stop me from continuing to put these videos out for you all, especially because this business is growing so fast. I wanna document everything as much as I can. Mark my words, all this grinding I'm doing 10, 20 years from now, it's gonna be cool as shit to look back at these videos. Do me a favor, give this video a like, comment down below, holler at me. I'll see you all in the next one. Always remember, no grind, no glory.